And with this sucker, we might be on the final table. And there it is. Final table, big 82, guys. We did it. No FT bubble. That was a pretty crazy FT bubble, I would say. Let's see how we do with the sevens. First hand on the final table, get queens. Sadly, not nine-handed yet. Ooh, we get the fold. We get the raise fold, man. What a pretty spot in that red 30 FT. Oh, this is a clean one. Come on, queens. Give me some action. Poker's expert. Go for the 4x. The 4x. We're like 4xing it. We know it. It's okay. It's okay. I take a min raise as well. We're in with 7s versus a6 and a bigger a6 and a bigger 27 and hold. We have 22k over there. Good luck. Let's hope he has pocket 8s and doesn't fold it this time. What will it be, guys? First, just folds. All right, final table time. Win the first pot of the... before the final table. So now we're on the official final table. Let's get rolling. Let's win this whole thing. Thanks, Yannick. Cool stuff. 7 of 9. Gonna put payouts on the screen as soon as someone busts over here. I will probably do the same now. Want a nice little pot with the sevens there. And we're obviously still in the hot 27 with a nice run. And we have a big stack in the 44 PKO. There's a bunch of tournaments I want to get into. I'm gonna late reg a bunch of them. Just because there's too much going on right now. Gonna defend the king 8 of diamonds. And you know, we kind of connect here. I mean, we could go for a check raise. Okay, now we're just leading. It's really tough spot for him to continue with like an ace 3, pocket 6s have a rough day. And he doesn't have that many 10x that he like checks back anyhow. He opens, he goes for the 2x3 bet. It ain't pretty, but we're just going in here with queens. Everything else is just cooler. I think I'm just jamming. See what MC Daggy does. Kind of an odd name. All in the final table, 13 blinds, ace queen suited. In the tank now. Give me that call, baby. Oof. No diamond. That's it. 36 blinds, just getting called off with the king 10. We get called in the final table by kings. The super short six wakes up with it. Can we hit that ace? Can we hit that ace? I'm Henry and I can always hit the ace, even a second one. There's always an ace, guys, especially when you're German, especially when your son running German. Let's go. All right, I think it's time to make payouts for this one. That's a little 400 up top. King check versus eights. Let's see some low cards for the first ladder. Low card! Boom! And now we can make the payouts for that one as well. There's actually one or two things going on at this point of the stream. We have some runs. I hope you guys are having a good time. Let's keep on running hard. I guess we're gonna get these payouts done first. Oh, here's 6k chips. Oof. Yeah, I mean, I can't refold 10-8. It's just the nuts, you know, the big blind. It's a good flop. Mm-hmm. And now it's about running good because we have an easy check jam here and just hope he folds or calls it with the sevens. Hold! Boom! What a nice spot. 9-8 is like the dream hand to see in that spot. Holy shit. Feels good, man. 92k, second off 8. Suddenly we're cruising on the fine table. Back in the mix, sucking out with queen 10 versus aces after getting cooler with checks versus kings. Right back in the mix and we're making the tricks. We're making the moves. Listening to them grooves. Electro swing running in the playlist. And Magnus is not good enough to find a rhyme on that. So I'm just going to put on the sailor's hat. It's a pretty sexy cap. Lots of swag. All right, let's go. Let's get some cruisins in the chat, guys. We have the cab, man. We're just absolutely cruising right now, okay? Absolutely cruising. Grandpa's groove. Nines into aces. FD hype. Oh man, chat is on fire. Jack 10 wins versus ace 8. Would rather see a bust out there. Trap. I like how she just randomly types in trap in the chat. That's a 3-bet call here. Press groove. It's a sick fine tail, by the way, big A2. Shit ton of fish. Ah, feels good, man. Come on. Freezing ball up here. On Germans and sun running Germans, the thing. I mean, when you reach the level of sun running where you even run better than a German, then that's what I mean. What a nice spot there. Dream spot from the 8-9 there. Man, I'm just gonna leave the sailor head on for the rest of the tournament, man. I'm feeling it right now. Play a game. I don't think we're bluffing a 7 here. I have 6-4, 6-5, all of that shit. Captain Lero right there, dude. Dude. This is my second career. If I'm not making it as a poker player, if I'm just fading at some point, I'm gonna go down the stripper. I mean, like, how good do I look with the hat? Like, seriously, like, how fucking good does it look? Dude, it's such a sick hat. I feel good. I feel sexy. Is King deep in our tour boat tournament? How do these guys get it in? I don't know. Good luck. San Rondero. But I think I would put the captain hat off, though. We need it for special occasions. And we can't. I feel good with it, you know. I feel sexy, but gotta keep it special. Get it in pretty good here for a 2 big blind pot. I'm running so poor, man. So poor. I can't even run like the 4 big 2 big blind pots, you know. You're the captain of Prophet Land now. Prophet Land sounds like a good place to be. I mean, we're working on it right now. What have we locked up? 280. Obviously, some money up here. Big stack here, big stack here, big stack there, big stack everywhere. We're second in chips here, so would prefer a fold. Man, we're 700 people in here. 1700. What's up, everyone? Let's fucking go. We're cruising a fine table in a poker tournament and another final table. It's a good life. 30 blinds over here. Second in chips for 30 blinds means there's gonna be a lot of action. Ooh, 17 days. I'm not going anywhere, man. You're gonna get your 1 year follow, your 2 year follow. Man, this guy is just fucking disconnects. Tonight. Home is whenever I'm with you. Aha! Welcome back home, Lord Bear. Cheers, mate. It is nice. Pocket chips to 80. Whoa! 90 now. Fast pass that much for her. Big pot here. Boat over boat. No ladder yet. The counterfeit, dude. I mean, at least fish wins versus regular, which is good. Don't know anything about him. I think as a default, I think I just limp here. Yeah. Make my way. To a boat tournament. It's a turbo tournament where you hit a boat every now and then, you know. You guys are not familiar with that because nobody like makes as many boats as I do. This is actually somewhat close with ace 4, but on a fine table, I just prefer to fold. Would like to see a diamond here, no king, no jack. And there we have our second ladder, and now I can put the payouts over here. Alright, let's put it like this. Whoop this. I'm gonna call the rejam here with nines. Ooh, stars nuts though. Stars nuts. Not even a sweat, easy nine. Alright, he comes in with the three bet. We're just rejamming here. If he folds like ace 5 suited, we're totally fine. Totally down for that, you know? Also, if he has jacks, we're just getting in now and he doesn't get away from like an ace queen deuce spot. If he has aces, it's unfortunate. If he has ace king, it's an ace, it's unfortunate. But let's hope that doesn't happen. It's tough to believe that he calls now after tanking. Maybe he has like an ace check after he was bluffing and now thinks about value calling. Well, like calling because he thinks I'm redeeming against like 5 or 4s. Maybe getting slowed by 8 or slowed by aces here, that would be fucking brutal. Nope, he folds. Alright. Maybe he wanted to make sure that we believe he's not 3-bet bluffing there. It ain't a shame to 3-bet bluff every now and then. You come back from 5k chips, yep. Start out with Queen 10 versus Aces. Easy game. Hi from Dubai. Let's go. Nice. What up, dude? Queen Jack versus Ace 8. No Ace, no 10. This is filthy. Why doesn't he just jam it? But yeah, we're not changing our play. Good luck. It's like the thing, like when people like click it back, they often have aces. So it's possible to make some hero folds there. The thing is, like, he didn't even click it today. Like, it was a 2x, and like, yeah, this SPR, he could do it with ace king as well, and maybe even checks. So, I think it's okay. It doesn't feel great. GG in hot 27. I wonder if he should make more hero folds there. He won 40k this week? Yup. I mean, a bit more than 40k, I'm just not sure how much more. All right, see another collie and a bust out. Nope. Gonna be all in the final table with my ace 8 and 12 blinds. Thanks, Rich. Rich Prodigy. Oh, that name sounds familiar for sure. Cheers, dude. OBS. Open Broadcaster Software. The studio version. Which you should use as well if you want to stream. It's free, super easy to use. I mean, not super easy to use, but it's easy to use once you get into it. 10 out of 10. Mr. Henry, if you keep going like that, you will be the next 10k viewers on Twitch. I just take, like, if you get 1k views on average, we're crushing. We are absolutely crushing with that. We'll see what the future brings. You know, I'm trying to stream a lot, but then on the other hand, I also want to like travel to some more live events, play some more live poker, maybe do some more IRL stuff while I'm at a live event. Who knows? Just want to have a good time in life, you know. Twitch is life. Twitch is love. Alright, ace king versus queens. If you see some low cards here, we would have another ladder. Not a 5 though. Ooh. This guy jams 11 blinds with a $60 bounty. We're hunting with the 3s. Alright, little flip. Flip Laro. Flip Laro. Flip Laro. I really like to see this. It's something I always forget about. The reason he does this is like because he's pretty much all in now. But if he rejams, he rejams, he rejams, and I rejam, he can fold. Pretty much never happens. But on average, he's going to make maybe like a cent with that. Seems good. Come home, home is whenever I'm with you. Guardian DE, thanks for the sub, dude. Welcome home, man. Appreciate it. Spent your Twitch Prime sub over here. Welcome, dude. I think I'll just bet here. He's gonna have like so many like 8-4 offs, 8-2 offs, 6-2 offs that we just get a bunch of folds. Also, we start building a pot if the turn is an ace. This is one of these spots where you just pray he doesn't have a flush, because if he has a flush, you're gonna be busting this tournament. Oh, now he's not folding king deuce, which is nice. So let's get value from that king deuce. All right, I was just hoping we don't get jammed on there. That was it. Good pot. I would usually open me a lot with like two fun players around, but these guys have been like somewhat active and aggressive, so I'm not doing it. All pennies for that Laro guy anyways. It's just, honestly, like subs are just amazing. It's like follower, but on a like VIP level kind of thing. And like, the money I make through like subs is like, not saying that it's not like that important, right? But it just feels fucking great to have like 265 subs at this point. Like to have a community, like 265 people that are willing to spend some money on you to support your channel. Like how fucking awesome is that? I mean, that's the reason like subs feel so fucking great. Gonna play in a mini starter, unlikely. Today I have like a lot of tournaments up already. First I want to like jump to the natural A tournaments because the value there is just the best. So as soon as I bust one of these FTs, I'm gonna fire up the red 100. And then I'm just gonna figure out what like the most profitable tournaments are, where I make the most money, and gonna play those. There's a lot of like interesting tournaments running right now, but I just really try to pay attention not to fire up too many, so I don't get distracted and make a lot of mistakes. Over here he limped and checks back the flop, which is really, really nice. When you have 10-5-0, would have just folded pre-flop, and now you have top pair. Before he checked back aces on the flop. Like, even if he trapped pre-flop, I think he just c-bets checks plus on the flop, so I feel really, really good there. Let me take it out. Yeah, I'm making a vlog at the German Millions. I mean, I will try to, if I get, like, super pissed about, like, doing a vlog. Because I'm not a big fan of, like, doing the vlog itself. It's nice to have it afterwards and you guys enjoy it a lot, but I'm not a big fan of like just putting the cameras into like a camera into random people's faces while I'm having conversations, you know. So I will try to do like a vlog and I hope it turns out good, but I'm not gonna like film like every conversation I have with like people I like and stuff like that. Easy jam here. Nice. Next one. Ace queen versus ace queen. He has a free roll. Doesn't get there. Oh, we're getting some fold jams. The roll over there. If it's nice. This clip. Why is it on there? Why? Yeah, cheers. I wave weird as Harvey. Yeah, I mean, that's the plan, you know. I'm never like partying on Saturday or Sunday, pretty much, on Friday or Saturday, because I want to be able to stream in the morning. Yeah, I can see a clip as well. Black starts blind down to like four blinds. All in now, 6-8 off versus A7. See 6-1-8 here. He limp called us over here with kings. And he plays against the German, so we naturally see a couple of fives on the flop. Feels pretty good, next $60 bounty. It's a bit disgusting, I have to say. Then again, I mean, like, win all the chips and now I have $60 more on my bounty, so see ya. Ba ba da ba do ba boopa dipa boopa da ba boopa ba 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 ba. Fat page. It's a good flop here. Let's just see a king deuce deuce flop. He has king 10 off king jack. Close, I would say. Like, I take an ace queen 10 flop and he has ace check, you know? Ooh, that's a small bet. When he bets range here, what do we want to do? Alright. He seems like a really, really good regular. I really like his sizing so far. We'll expect like something around half pot to the two thirds now if he bets. Wow, he really makes it filthy for us, hey? I think on a fine table, I want to rejam here. It's kind of tough to balance it out, so I always have value. The thing is, like, he's not going to go for a third street with like ace king anyhow, and if he has two pairs, he's not folding, so I think like jamming is the way to go. Boom! And if you just call turn, he might just give up and check back that river. We're one of six, running fucking hard. It's insane. Let's go, guys. Holy shit. No, that's not too nitty, Anders. I would have folded. I mean, he's got to turn like a queen check into a bluff or something like that. He might raise a queen check before. I just don't think he has that many bluffs. I totally agree with you. I would fold as well. Oh, baby. We're chip leading this final table, man. Just running so hard. Want to put like an unlucky into the chat, kind of, but he probably disclosed already. I mean, he, as I said, like I'm really really happy with how he played now. But like he played solid, you know. Like, GG. We just run hotter, you know. That's pretty much it. Ooh, triple all in. Let's hope he wins it. All right, king or queen would be nice for double KO. And now we just need to fade an ace on 8 and be three-handed. Yep. There it is, guys. Three-handed Lero. Let's take it down. Big ladder here between the two places. Oh, he raises. Ah. Expect to see a lot of folds there, but we hope he had a hand he can call. These guys are quite active, so we could limp this one as well. What I'm trying to say. Oh. We bet call flop here with the queen nine. He's probably rejamming a bunch of his ace-x pre-flop, so pretty easy spot. End of what I'm trying to say. I mean, this is also a good turn. Hope he doesn't have aces now. Gonna call it off here with ace deuce. Good luck, guys. 10 big blind jam. Can't fold. It's, most of the times, this is a chop. And now we need to do 5. 5! Sad we don't chop there. GG in third place for 150. Turn is a queen here. And we all in. Drifting away. Yeah, and he makes the fold. Figure out what I was going to say. So yeah, we're jumping the red 100 over here. Closing down the payouts now. Sad third finish there, but obviously can't complain much there. What a sick heat have you on, man. Like, fuck me, man. It's so ridiculous. Remember. Drifting away. Must be nice to be Bolero. It is, man. What? These are some odd stats. That must be a sample size thing. Oh, I'm still gonna call it. Damn. I was so ready to fold this. All right, now we have an easy flop fold at least. Like, I want to just fold this pre-flop, but doesn't seem like he had 3 bets, but he does fire some big blind 3 bets. So yeah, quick update. We still have this nice second of 44 PKO. Actually, there's a break coming out 20 minutes. I'm just going to do it then. Well, this drop is pretty sick. Gets me fired up every time. Are you ready to be fired up, boys? Oh, this could be a fun player only FT. And me. I don't know, I don't feel like he plays terrible though. Did he rejam 7s versus an open, or did he open jam and then he called? Thanks, Aaron. I mean, he looks also somewhat solid. Guess we fold over here. Who dodging bullets, boys? Yeah, I can't fold versus the sizing. but I prefer raising it. Actually, no, I don't even need to raise it here. He's just gonna have an ace of hearts X hand, and he checks it back on the river pretty often, and which is good with our six. Okay. Maybe I should have raised. Things like if I raise turn there and bet river, we always get a fold if the river's non-hard, I think. GG, rip the praise. Yeah, I just can't fold getting 3-1 here. Let's go. Give me some clubs on the flop, some top pairs, some top twos. I take that as well, you know, just an easy fold is not bad in an awkward spot like that. 10-9 bots could be quite awkward here. So yeah, nice that we can just let it go. Pretty sure you don't want to pair with that sizing as well. I mean, he can obviously be bluffing there as well. 9-3 3 bet calling here for 14. Over here, we're just going to turn a spade. Nope. I could have raised the flop. I have so many like two pairs there. What the fuck is he doing? Hold. Thank you. Sick, man. Like, what are these guys doing, man? It's like Sunday, I guess. I'm not impressed. I'm going to the moon who wants to go, dude. I'm already there. Just need to check out my sharks with craft, like straight to the moon right now. Yeah, I think I'm not gonna fire up too many tables. Just gonna chill with my six tables, and if we bust the tournament, I'm gonna fire up like a 1-9 starter, something like that. Don't really wanna have like that many tables on at the same time. I live in Edinburgh, in Germany, close to Basel right now. Gonna see what's small here with the ace-10 and call off. What's up, Gangster Rabbit? What's up, Easter? All right, let's see a check on 9. Check 9. Nope. Good luck is king here, double booty opportunity. Huge pot, super important one. Holy shit, what is he doing? Hold it. That's a great start, don't give him a club, don't give him a club. Ah, no 8, no 7, come on. Yeah, wow, he just rejams like 50,000 chips there. It's absurd. Easy eyes of the nines over here. Lord, we have all the chips now and all the bounties and the bounty on the 63 as well. Sadly flipping. Stars nuts though, 8-9. Ooh, disappointing. And no ace, no check for another ladder here. That was a sick pot with ace king, man. I have 70,000 on this bounty 63. This could be a fun final table. Thanks, Harrison. Extra sharp. So yeah, one of 18, 10 paid. Could be good. Really? I mean, I do have a headset here. I just prefer these. I'm not gonna fold many hands, but this is one of them. I think I'm gonna. I mean, he's been somewhat active. I'm just gonna limp. Thought about raising, like, more of a sim. But then again, I don't really want to play big pots right now. I mean, this is, we're such a big favorite in this lineup. 2K viewers, by the way. Pretty nice. Welcome, everyone. So, small pot seems like a good strategy, you know? Still have a pretty good shot in cashing this one, even after losing with the nines. I have a 3 minute delay. But obviously it's important for me to have a delay, otherwise my opponents could just watch the stream and see my cards at the, in real time, right? So, gotta make sure that's not happening. Alright. Let's collect some more bounties here. I feel pretty good. Gonna be an easy 3-bet call. Thanks, Aaron. Let's get some more bounties here with aces. Oh, great spot for these guys to rejam. Let's go. I mean, I wouldn't mind him. I mean, like, he just rejammed, like, versus my turn lead for 50 blinds. No. Just gonna rejam here versus unknown fish for 25 blinds. Expecting him to raise too much here. If he calls, you know, you fire a second bullet. But yeah, I think we just see a bunch of folds there. Comes in with the button limp now. I think I'm just gonna see a flop with the check nine. Okay. So now we just need to think about how his limping range is built. Some people don't really like, he has a low c-bet frequency. Not sure if he should call you with implied odds. I don't know. Like, heads up, I like calling because we like get a bluff through quite often, but I'm not really sure this works. Three raise. We're exactly in Germany. Yeah, I keep that private, but close to Basel, pretty much. So just go with Basel. Yeah, I live like on the German side though. Like, just I can see Basel from my window, pretty much where I'm at right now. She should edit the coaching command. Decent board. Going for the min bet flop. Two-thirds turn. Probably two-thirds river. Three doesn't change a whole lot. I'm just gonna bet two-thirds. Not sure what the tank on the floor exactly means. I feel like it's a bit more likely he has a like king four when he does a float like that. But this is pretty absurd. I don't think I've ever seen a bluffy in my entire life, but you never know with versus a fish. Fuck, is that ridiculous? Have I ever seen a bluff here? I mean, he tanks flop, so just gonna fold. I know, especially with like the way he tanked on the flop, I feel like he had a hand that he wanted to raise on the flop already, but it was like, I think he's just bets all shit ton here. Yeah, just going for a tight fold. I think it's the right play, it doesn't feel good though. But, yeah. But you probably don't get like exploited there. It's my intel, it's me. Three blinds, just chilling. I like the fold, I think it was the right decision. I mean, that's the reason I went for it. Oh. It's been a while since someone got knocked out here. I mean, he's really, really short this entire time. Just managed to stay alive. Staying alive. He goes for the limp call with King 7. Definitely noteworthy. And he stays alive again. I'm not saying like the limp call is necessarily terrible. I just don't understand why you wouldn't just open jam it. I just got a fold here. Kind of sucks. But I mean, we have two squeeze jamming stacks. And his opening range is not that tight either. It's not that wide either. So like we gotta hope that these guys flat behind and then we just take it to flop multi-ways, nobody jams, and then we have to hope that we flop good. And then we have to hope that even if it's the top kicker, he doesn't have ace king or aces here, so I like the fold. That is pretty ridiculous though. This is a fucking filthy spot if you're in this one, with like an ace queen or something. Oof. Didn't expect to see the flat, but now he's gonna call as well. I mean, can't we fold here getting 10k into 50k, like would. I'm gonna throw a call over here. Alright, I really hope somebody has a 10, and then we have aces on the other hand. And see some more KOs. Oh, does he have a 10? Pretty unusual spot to go for a lead. Wow, he was actually 6 of the money now in a bigger 22. Just gonna get the cash and then go from there. Give me the cash. We have a queen five from middle position. We have 6 of the money in this bounty tournament, so I'm really, really opening up my ranges and start applying lots of pressure to these guys. This is live. Stand man. Oh, my back hurts a bit, man. Fuck this fucking chair. Don't think you can fold a queen there. I mean, I think I can. Ace king for a ladder. Nope. Man, it's so sick how everyone stays alive in this one, really. He could have been full of shit, yep, he could. I think it's such more likely though he had it. It could also have been a unicorn or a bot. True, there's many things it could be. Alright, come on, check 5. This could be a bit weird. Thanks, Dan, man. Just fold on into a 4 big blind jam. I think I fold to a 5 big blind jam with 7-4 off, if that's the one you're referring to. Which I think is certainly correct. They check around the flop, so I feel really good about my hand on the 6th turn. I mean, they could have pocket 6s or some stuff, but just not that often, I think. So I'm gonna go for the bet here, just protect my hand. I mean, it could have something like 8-5, obviously, but not that likely. Nice. Alright, gotta take it easy, man. The most important thing if you want to start playing poker is like start low. Start really, really low. And stick to your bank of management, alright? If you're tilted, don't take shots at higher buy-ins, alright? The important thing is like try everything you can to make only one deposit, okay? Now you can flat the king queen here on the button. Alright, so set this as your main goal, not to deposit again. Really pay close attention to the money you have and stick with that, okay? Just play like if you have a deposit $100, play like 50 cent tournaments. Stick to them all the time. If your bankroll goes down to $50, play 20 cent tournaments. Usually I bet like small with range here. I'm not really sure how this guy being short affects this though. So I think I'm gonna check it back. Like bet folding kind of sucks here because we have four outs to the nuts. We have the backdoor diamonds, and obviously a king or a queen could just give me the best hand. So if you would have been deeper there, I would definitely start bluffing flop. He decided against it, and I think it's the correct thing. It's a pretty sad turn to see. But obviously he didn't get the prize to draw for that 10. That could have been a real fun spot. Oh, especially when he has the queen, man. Ace is over here. Nice little spot here, building up. He's in the tank now. It's pretty dirty. I mean, he's got to turn like an 8 in the bluff. I would assume most fun players are not doing that. Or some flush draw that he didn't see bet on the flop. Ooh. Come on, hard run, Lero. Let me hold here. Ace. I lost the pot, guys. It might not be rigged after all. Alright, we're getting in over here with all of my top pair flush draw shit. Alright, let's fade a 3 order. Nice. Booty, $15. Let's go. He's deep in a tang, man. I would love a call here. I really believe all that has it. But I'm also interested to see if it does, if it's possible for him to not have it here. I mean, maybe as a 7 or thinks about it, I guess. Open aces, c betting flop, jam turn. So he doesn't have two pairs, so he's like a king queen. I take a king jack here. No, pair the board. Thank you. Good hold. Thanks, FTBAZ. I prefer to grind as well. Not a big fan of like Fastnacht. Carnival or whatever you want to call it. Wearing jeans in your own apartment, yeah. We gotta wait for like the button and the small blind to bust, you know. That's the main goal right now, get that. Those extra $350 locked up and then see if we can not go for the win after that. All right, King 10. Hard. It doesn't stop, man. This has been an absurd, like, six-handed game. I would have still killed on while playing poker. I think a kill might be pretty GTO. Yeah, it's life. I'm quickly cutting between different apartments and shit. I mean, I guess I just gotta go for the third pot fold here. Depends what we expect this range to look like of 14 blinds. Just expected him to not have many pocket pairs in there, so he should prick that board pretty often. Yeah, I mean, I started with 100 bucks 2 years ago, like, I grinded up from those 100 to my current state, bankroll. This one is going in. Yeah, I'm not playing $3 blinds anymore. Those days are over. I estimate like the short stack won like the last 5 all ins here at least. In the 6-hand game. It's been an absurd amount. It's a pretty nice run out for ace 4. Wow. So she says right now that she checked the board twice. Set. Don't think it's happening, so we're just rejamming and hope she has some type of value hand. Like, she probably just has ace4 here, I think, but let's hope she has something else. Alright, so he checked, she checked now ins twice. GG in the red 100, I think it's super unlikely to happen, so I like my rejam. Unfortunate river. Thanks, Green. Not sure how to say your name, dude. I'm sorry. Yeah. I mean, $82 buy-in doesn't mean people have to be good, especially on a Sunday. We could also limit the check-ins here. Maybe that's better, honestly. Yeah. Yeah, it feels kind of better to limp here, honestly. Like, it just sucks to get jammed on here, you know? I want to see a flop with the check-in suited. Pretty funny spot. I'm going to call 4-5 off here. Right. Nah, actually it's close. Going to fold. Big blind defense. I think I'm going to go for the delayed bet here. I'm not sure, maybe you should just c-bet. The thing is just, we would have to bet fold, and even if you're behind on the flop, there's like an ace-8, I have like 30% here and shit. So just kind of felt kind of bad to fold there. I had to bet fold there. Maybe it's still the play, because so much of his range just bricks that. Like usually I would just c-bet there. I don't know, it just felt kind of wrong with Jack-10 of hearts, but probably just a mistake. Sometimes I withdraw, but I mainly just build bank. It doesn't matter, like, I just have money in different parts. I don't really want to talk too much about it. But I don't really have a separated bankroll, like poker bankroll or life roll. We've off the money in this one. So everybody's really, really tight. Given how bounty tournaments work on that trade. If you don't know how they work, just type exclamation mark bounty in the chat. Because it's quite important to understand how bounty tournaments work on that trade to realize like why I'm doing certain things at this point. over here with three bet calling queens. Studied a lot. Alright, good luck. Just watch like training videos on upswing poker. It's like a pretty good start to get to get better at poker. Alright, big flip here. I mean, big pot, not really a big flip besides that. Problem with that losing that is just that my stack gets more vulnerable, so I have to be really tight given my bounty. I'm gonna try to come along here. Because whenever it's 30,000 on Monday, finished 23rd out of 45,000 runners in the Sunday Million for 30 grand. I don't want to lead here because, like, if I lead here and he jams, my life is just over, you know? I can just quit poker forever and never come back. Sizing feels kind of weird, to be honest. I feel like if he had ace king, he would bet bigger. But maybe it's just me being... Yeah, probably. This doesn't feel good. It's versus that turn sizing. So he just checks it back with, like, nines. And he has a weaker king. Nice, 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 nice. Let's see what the hands are. A7 and queen check. Just decided to stab it on the turn. Which is good for me. Go for the steal over here. The c-bet is never bad. We have a range advantage. We should clearly c-bet king 10 on queen 4 deuce. That's never the question if we should c-bet there or not. That is just a 100% super clear c-bet. Yeah, I totally support myself with poker. It's not that I have any other job. I mean, it takes up too much time to have another job. I mean, I work a lot. Also, it doesn't make sense to have another job if I'm just making, like, good amounts of money here. All right, we finally cashed this one with three blinds. Good. Well, then I just blind out. So, like, when my internet connection is out, then it means my cards automatically folded every hand. Means I'm just folding, paying, like, these blinds. And at some point, I would have no chips and I would bust. Man, stacks are really weird here. Let's see a KO, man. It's been a long, long time since we've seen a KO. That's another flip. This time looks good for the bigger stack. And there it is. He needed a check on the river for the chop now, on that king turn. It was a really good turn. And we get 200 bucks extra. No, I don't watch training videos on YouTube. I have like some site that I don't want to share where I watch training videos, and yeah, that's about it for now. I used like the Upswing FTT Masterclass in the past. It's worth run it once. Both are like really good. But that's about it. Right now I watch it somewhere else. Sorry guys, just have to do something for the command here. There we go. Good luck. Yeah, I started at the real low stakes of grind up. Bad play at this hand. Thanks, dude. I was really not sure, and your comment of bad play at this hand really helped me improve. Thanks, dude. 40%. GG. Van Fant now in the bounty, Hunter 63. And it's time to fire up another tournament. What is it gonna be? I guess we fire up the hot 82. Nice little $82 turbo, you know? Why not? Hands. There's an argument to be made for a much smaller size in the board with the range king ten offhand. Didn't I bet a third? So, seems totally fine to me. I mean, if you want to bet a quarter there, seems fine as well, but I don't think it's going to make a huge difference in our EV. Yep. I mean, I played poker before that, just really recreationally. When I start to think, hey, I want to take this more seriously, that's when I start streaming. Can I get a Weymouth of call here? Let me think about this. I guess I can call her. Whew, good decision, Henry. Not by that outcome, but the price just a bit too good as we get a sub who brings the run good apparently. NT Arlequin. Thank you, dude. Welcome home. He checks it back. Unusual board. If you check a lot, check is a good card for me. I'm gonna have a lot of good hands here. I really hope he doesn't have queens here. That would just be really filthy. Yeah, we're just gonna lead here. I just really hope he doesn't have queens. I mean, queens would just be so filthy here. Or checks. Checks is also a hand he has here. Oh, please. I mean, he wouldn't jam a boat here, right? Boom. Let's go. Woo, baby. Now we have the chip lead. What a flop. What a flop. Yeah, I'm originally from Germany. All right, good luck. Oh, fuck. I can't even call even a stone bubble. Holy shit. I shouldn't have opened tens. I mean, dome is fine, I guess. Wow, I almost called it. We're in a stone bubble, right? This is $280 bubble for me. I can't obviously do anything. Good hand. I don't know why we have an addiction to press this button. It just feels good to be first, you know, and just press it. It's the first. Good, good, good. Nice, Dr. Yunusos. I hope I see you there, man, in, I don't know, 2 years or something. Keep it up. Wednesday, I'm going to Rosslauf. Tomorrow, I'm driving to Nuremberg. Relax for 2 days and then Roswaff. Says, man, you're gonna get banned soon. Like, this is a promise right now. If you keep on like starting that topic to tilt me, I'm gonna ban your ass. Seize 233 only, okay? This is your last warning, dude. Stop talking about that shit. I don't want to be sponsored by PokerStars. It's done. You're good. Thanks. Ah. I know you're just doing it to troll me at this point, so. Just don't do it, because people actually pick on it and they're like, yeah, why not, and shit. Z. He's done. I'm done. I just can't deal with that shit. That's okay, Suicide Durke, or whatever your name is. Just the other guy, he just does it to troll and it's enough. So sick that I just have to fold everything here. Even a stone bubble, I just can't do shit. Can do something with kings. I'm not from Bayreuth. I studied there for a year and lived there for that reason, but I'm not from there. I'm half, like half my family comes from the Regensburg area, the other one from Freiburg, or Freiburg. Weiss was ace check. And no ladder yet. We flop top set here. I'm just gonna c-bet. Versus regulars. Just can't do anything here but else but c-bet. When I will c-bet range, I also get a c-bet kings. Hope he trapped us with aces pre-flop. And I'm just gonna check this. And yeah, just stack his aces here. I feel pretty good about this one. We get it in hot 82, flipping. Alright, he jams now. We have the nuts and he has aces as expected, and that's a pretty good flop. Just a disgusting hard run. But we lose the flip over here and have to buy in again for another 82 bucks. I'm not running ads, that's all up to Twitch. Just gonna fold here. We made the money, guys. Awesome. Let's make the final table now as well. Those stats you need to use a program like Hold'em Manager 2, exclamation point HUD can give you the link. I had some coaches along the road. I still have some people I look up to that I'm friends with that I talk with every now and then. I think it could be a fine spot where he does like some 3-bet folding. I think this particular guy doesn't have many 3-bet folds in his range. The thing is like he made his 3-bet so small that we just get too good of a price to fold ace-5 suited. And it's kind of nice that we also run hot enough to like just get the perfect flop, right? I think it's not unreasonable to 4-bet jam there, but I mean he's not the guy you want to do it with, right? So pay attention to your opponent if he's preferably from Brazil or in Russia. Becomes a better play. Doesn't seem bad. Guys, enjoy your trip. Thanks, man. Can't wait. Like just a crazy week streaming, lots of fun over the last like month and a half. I streamed really consistently for 1 month now, and just kind of excited to also like just relax a bit, you know, get back the energy, come back, and then keep on winning. Ace queen was so obvious there. I'm not sure, man. I feel like a lot of people do c-bet ace queen. Also, a lot of people don't go for the 2.4x 3-bet with ace queen off there. They just jam it. But yeah, maybe you have a better read there than me. Heaven. Alright, let's see what the East Queen. Just gonna fold. He hasn't done that much. We saw him raise in a similar spot with tens, but obviously East Queen, we can't do much. Hopefully he has like Ace Jack or some like Queen Jack offhand that he folds. Good luck. So he's not multi-tabling, because usually at this point we do have the best hand here, or we're flipping. Let me come home. Thanks, dude. Welcome back home, Marbok. Cheers. Let's do it. Großer Strom. What do you check? Much energy? Such power? Lots of power? What do you check? Path, what did you check online there? Ah, yeah, Hof. Nice, nice. If ich treffe deine Sister am Wochenende. Oder ich mein morgen. Ich kennt mich deine Schwester, wäre auch witzig. Let's raise it here. I just feel like he's an... I mean, he I saw him before, but that was only once. I'm not sure. Ah, tens just feels better as a raise here. He goes for a 3x. We're gonna defend here. And now we just check fold. Hello, Speedy. Yeah, just so many people ask about the bankroll, and I'm just... doesn't matter, so we had to go for a trolley command there. Part of it, I mean, it's nice when the variance isn't as big in the morning as in the evening, but the main reason I stream in the morning is because there's less competition between Twitch streamers. Not like in the night, like all the big streamers are on, whereas in the morning, not really. I also just enjoy it personally more to be up in the morning. Like the main reason I think is also like that the two main reasons. It's like less competition, and the other reason is just it's really nice to get up nice and early and have somewhat of a real life in the evening. You know, my friends, they go to university or and have like a normal job, so they're also free to do things in the evening. You know, and there's some social life. Who's us Canada? Nice, he's connect and try. Canada is the place to be, guys. I've been streaming for 2 years now. Today, just check the bottom right and you can see the uptime and how long I've been streaming today. Why am I streaming in English? More people understand English and German. So I just started out in English and now I have like a lot of friends that don't speak German, so it doesn't make any sense to switch. Oh, do we get a ladder here, king or queen? Nope. No, he's really short. What a weird final table, man. This feels like an odd final table. It takes forever. Nobody has a real stack. I mean, look at his stack sizes here. Going for a thin value bet on the river. He called us with check high for the chop. That was pretty good. I mean, my goal was like, kind of to get a queen check to call, but I mean, if people call for the chop... Chop, I mean, we're printing. Speaking of printing, top two is usually a hand we're printing with. Ah, he ain't going anywhere here, I feel it. We're gonna check raise, go for it all. There's so many turns to just get our action versus an overpair here. Come on, just stack off with ace queen. Or an 8-9. Not sure why you would do that, but I would appreciate it. He just calls, he's committed. Good luck, guys. Please don't have like a 6-9 of spades or pocket sevens for some reason. Good luck. Bam! Bam, 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 come on! Oh, baby, man, the heater! Let's go. Heater Lara, man, it is filthy, it is filthy. The money that is being won on the stream is just filthy. King 8 with the jam, the small blind, get the fold. It is filthy. Alright, just a 7 for the KO. Nope. Jam my last 5 blinds over here. I live in Scotland. Edinburgh. And over here, I'm gonna raise call the big blind, even though it ain't pretty. Let's go down here first. If you get called with the force, I'm gonna switch over there. And may the pocket force be with us. Get two calls by deuces and check eight. Hold! Hold! Haha, we're right back in there. Nice. So he makes the call and he open jams with an easy fold. Let's hope he has queen check and makes the call. Pocket queens, went for the trap. I don't mind it. Oof, what a turn though. Also, fine table and bounty hunter 63 now. Fine table number Three of the day, I think. It's Booger's luck or skill. Both. Can I rant about Carnival? Feel free to do it, man. I'm not a fan either. I was in a pub yesterday and like some people came in and I was already like, just get the fuck out of here, okay? Like, just get out of here. It's not for me, man. There's people dressed like fucking emojis. Oh, okay, yeah, you're free to rant about that. Do you ever do deals on Fine Tables? Yeah, I mean, if the deal is in my favor, then yes, or if the variance is so huge that I rather just lose a bit of EV, but therefore have saved money. Like, if I make the Sunday Million Fine Table, it makes sense for me to take a deal. Are you up 40k this week? Actually, more than 40k, but yeah. Social life in 2018, they giggle. Yeah, I don't want to talk much about crypto, sorry. It's a fan here. Good flop. I'm not going to play any of the Turbo series. It looks absolutely terrible. I played the Millie, had a deep run, right? I know how it feels to run deep in a big MTT. And to imagine doing that same thing in a fucking Turbo series is like the most absurd shit ever. Let's call for the chop here. Kind of feel like we lose to King Jack here. I check back a Queen. Seems okay. Can't really fold for that sizing. Thanks for making it cheap. I just save my money. I don't really need anything. I have everything I have, so I want some. Just save it. I'm 21. Been playing poker for forever. I mean, I played when I was like 10 years old with friends, you know. Gonna go for the squeeze in the red 240. Didn't see much of that tournament yet. Nice little $240 buy-in. Thanks a lot, Kleingeld. An autograph, dude. You want to see my signature? You don't want an autograph by a guy with my signature. Like, I'm totally down to take a picture or something. But dude, come on, man. Like, I'm just a kid streaming on Twitch, dude. I can't go for an autograph, man. Like, what the fuck? How do I do that? I literally, you know, like every normal person, when they turn like, let's say like 14, 15, they think of a cool signature. I was always way too lazy to do that. So I still like my signature looks like, I don't know, an 8-year-old has a cooler signature than me. I'm down for a picture, okay? Like, if you want to do that, sure. But, dude, I can't give you a signature, man. It's just not happening. It's just not happening. But yeah, I'm totally down for a chat. I don't mind if people ask German, like in German occasionally. I prefer English overall because then I don't have to answer a question twice. This ain't pretty. This ain't pretty. I mean, he has to have like a queen check with the queen of diamonds he floats us with to have a bluff here. Doesn't fold too much to C bets. The thing is, like, even 4-3, 4-5 has some showdown value here. So it's just really filthy, and I just don't really see the bluffs that much. So I'm giving up. Much fun. I hate this, yeah. So that's the chip graph. Oh yeah, that would be a fun one. Ooh, 1 second here. I think we're going for a squeeze, man. Yeah, this is just a bit too nice. Nice, that's the thing we want to see. The quick fold there, the quick fold from the button. The quick button fold is what I want to see in that spot. Nice, nice, nice. Chip graph, oh yeah, sure. Actually, I don't want to show you the chip graph because then the overlay might be fucked. So, gonna do that later, okay? After the tournament. Hey, we guaranteed a 4-figure score. Poke chap. These guys, man. Like, the funny thing is, like, they're recreationists, but they don't play, like, absolute terrible poker. Like, they're lacking like some fundamentals, but they play solid, man. They are smart people, I would assume. They just haven't played much poker. This kind of sucks, especially in this flop. Alright, GG. And we're gonna bet like a third, a bit bigger. Kind of want to bet get value here from a king queen type hand. What the fuck? You're telling me you have king four? I don't see a bluff here ever. So I'm just folding, but guess he just river to pair. I'm going to jump in the 1-9 Sunday starter now. So yeah, we're kind of even three-handed here. Let's run better than the other guys. Thanks, Christina. Alright, guys, there's a bit too much in chat going on. I can't answer everything at the moment, so I apologize for that. But especially three-handed. I mean, if you can put it into sub mode, guys, maybe that's the best. I mean, we have 2,200 viewers. It's just really tough for me to read anything, and I don't really want to miss messages from subs. So mods, you can put into sub mode if you want. Ooh, clean river. Clean river. I mean, even before like 10-3 or some shit. I take a queen 4-0. That's just like a spot where he does have more bluffs, obviously, so we would also call pretty wide. I mean, ace-5, you can almost think about raising. If I send you a star and a star suit, will you sign it? It's just in Henry would refuse his children autographs. I mean, like, I don't know. Send nudes. Whew. Clean arrow. We all in with the best hand. Can we hold for 12k pot? Deuce. Nice. Is there any value in raising? He doesn't have ace king here, I don't think, so we should kind of raise, but I don't think people are like bet calling an 8 here. I just don't see how he ever has ace king though, so I kind of want to raise. Yeah, okay, let's do it. Shows 3-6. Oh, nice. No, 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 can't 3-bet. So yeah, we're on the bounty on the 63, final table. I locked up a $240 bounty, so I'm guaranteed 280. First place pays 640 for me. Nice little 10x. But it's not playing a party, the morning schedule is just terrible. No, I don't know. Disco Halifax. Oh shit, they get it in. Big stack win. Oh. Never 3-bet Lero. But I'm then going to ask you for a pick, sure. Let's have a little chat, I'm down. Oh, pot size Batman. This is gonna be a fun one. Let's win this tournament, man. 2k up top. Wow, he pots it and gets clicked. There's no. Alright, alright. I was like, there's no way he folds it. GG, we heads up. Alright, another heads up for the boys. Little $400 heads up match. Man, this was just to be so sick if we just win this again. I mean, let's do it. GG. Good luck. Smiley face. Is he German? Otherwise, I will say viel Glück. He's Kreese. Good luck. Kalimera. Tikanis. Now, every now and then you gotta be nice on the poker table as well. Nice little even heads up match. Stack wise. It's probably not skill wise. The thing with heads up is like, even if you like are much better than a guy, it's just two flips and you're out, you know? So it's not that I'm a huge favorite to win this. I am a favorite, but not a huge favorite. Let's gonna just pay attention, see how he plays. And he does have a low c-bet frequency. I'm gonna pay this once. Like a kind of a lead on the river, to be fair. Yeah, going for the lead here. I know what he said, color easy. Are you kidding me? He had the flush there 100% of the time. I'm just not gonna pay off these river raises. I mean, maybe later on, but not in the beginning. Just don't really see how he checks back like an a6-6 bluff and then turns up with a bluff later on. This could be a fun one with the checks. 15 off the money. Good luck. Oh, yes! That's a cooler for him with the sixes, obviously. But I take it, we have a stack now on the hot 82 as well. Lol. How about path not a mod? Alright, let's see about here. Five of diamonds on the turn. Kapow! Let's see. I like to double barrel this. And triple barrel on the heart. Nice. I'm gonna call the gut shot. And obviously an overcard. This one comes down to often he double barrels a check here. I'm gonna call again. I think queen high is good enough often. Or good enough often enough. And obviously we have to redraw to the nuts. Alright, he had a check here, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, he double barrels king check, which I think is really, really reasonable. There's just a lot of people that don't do it. I like it. I like it. I don't think it's bad. This is gonna be playing as a 3-bet. I'm gonna check it versus a limp. Not really sure what his limping range looks like at all. I assume it doesn't have many asex in it. Okay, keep it in mind, keep it in mind. I mean, he might be a decent player, honestly. Like he did that. Yeah, he just plays a bit weird, you know. Like I don't feel like he's absolutely terrible, you know. Like he's not a fish level. Just seems like a fun player with a brain, you know. Win, please. What's up, Remax? Let's do it. I think 5 hearts. We just check him back, and it's kind of interesting on the river. I mean, he's got to turn like. I mean, he can have queen check here and shit. Yeah, I'm gonna get a call here. Yeah. That's the reason we got a call river there. It's nice to see him bluffing it as well. But this is what I mean, like, pretty reasonable hand with the queen 10 there by him. Well, here we have a bit of an interesting spot. I hope mace king, I check call the flop, check check on the turn. He doesn't really bet many asex usually. But it's tough to get a bluff as well. But he might just do it, so I'm gonna check it. I mean, maybe some people bet ace check here, but most of them are just not. Let's see what he had. Sevens, yeah. I feel like sevens is never calling the river if I bet there. Seven through two, I'm not falling to a 3-bet in position. Yeah. Especially when you flop Lero. Oh, what a sizing. What a sizing. Oh, let's go. Alright, let's just hope he doesn't have pocket eights. Just have like checks and let me hold here. Versus a check, we could bet like a third. Watch it get back and hope he catches some action himself. I'm going for the check. I'm going for the check. The decision has been made. I don't think the 10 should change a lot. And now we're betting. I just hope we get called by maybe sevens or something like that. Just gonna make it half pot to guarantee a call from sevens and some of his high calls. If he jams here, I hate my life, but we just lose to like pocket eights pretty much. And I think he would bet four step big on the flop, so since he loses like one hand, I'm probably not folding. But it wouldn't be pretty. Alright, good pot. He's under 30 blinds now. It's nice to bet big on the flop, you know. That way we got obviously more value while he was still bluffing. If he just bets a third there, like the result's pretty much the same, but he loses less chips. Pretty good bluff, river bluffing spot. Nice, come on. Gonna continue raising for now. Might obviously adjust my strategy at a later point. So I think it's time to go over to a limping strategy. I mean, he does this 2.5x 3-bet thing a decent amount of the time, you know. So I guess, yeah, I'm gonna start limping. I mean, it's also fine to raise, and because this is like a hand, I can easily call this a 2.5x. But still doesn't feel that great. I'm gonna c-bet here, actually. It's not like a hand where you get a lot of folds on the flop, I think, on our spot. But I think on the... on the turn where we get a bunch more folds. Just gonna check it here. Wow, what the fuck? So he checks behind ace check versus the limp. What hands is he 3-betting then? I mean, what the fuck? That should just be such a clear raise. I mean, what does it mean now? I guess we're just limping king queen. Yeah, I think like we should keep this pot small for sure. I mean, if he doesn't even raise like ace check, like... I mean, I guess it gives him like way more asex as well in these spots. I'm gonna pay this once. With like that many draws out there, he might just lead a draw once to give it up later. I think we call for info here. Yeah, that's pretty absurd. Like he plays an odd style of poker, I have to say. Like when it comes to these little things. Alright, just raise more of these min bets. It just means like we should raise him, and if he checks it, we can just bet every time because like he checks when he min bets weak showdown value. That means he just checks hands that don't have showdown value, right? I mean, suddenly our bets are becoming really, really good. We're jamming this on the funny table, and we go for the c bet down here. Oh baby, miss whenever I'm with you. Yeah, okay, let's just bet 70k and get a fold, hopefully. Let's go. Nice! Come on, gambit with this up. Thanks a lot, dude. Welcome back home for the 4 month. As we get the triple barrel through, feels good, man. Feels good. I gotta be careful with the raises. I still wanna do it, kind of. Just gotta be careful. Alright, come on. All right, interesting. He just jams his flush draw, I assume. Ooh. I mean, he's gonna fold a lot here, but this is just such a good hand to raise. Yeah, we're just aiming here and just hope he doesn't have to flush. Good luck. Oh my god. Oh, what a filthy turn. What a filthy turn. We're back to even. Fuck, that sucks. Just hits the 3-out on the turn right there. I guess he has an ace as an out, but on an ace I don't go proc, obviously. Foo. I mean, it's the end, just always plays out like this. There's nothing we can do. Is he celebrating right now? Good luck with the queens and the 1-9 starter. Where's ace king? Good old flip. We flop a boat. Nice. He tanks forever then raises. I guess we're just calling. We're in a stone bubble in the hot 82, by the way. Have some good runs right now. Yeah, now we can just bet. Because we saw him lead like a deuce in a spot like this. So this should always get a fold. So this is already something we know how to exploit him. Over here, really nice turn. So I check back the flop with ace check. The thing is just if I bet here and we get jammed on, I have to fold my hand, which is obviously fucking horrible. That's the reason I check this back, and obviously turn is pretty nice. So this is like a turn where he probably bluffs a lot. That's the bet I'm gonna call. Also over here, I'm calling a 3-bet. Sadly break the flop. Let's see what the river brings here. We have the nuts, which is really, really nice. When you're on the stone bubble of a tournament versus a guy that has more chips than you, that's likely to bluff a bunch. He checks it. I'm gonna tank a bit and bluff. Well, you bet, but I mean, just make it look a bit bluffy. Come on, I have like ace king with the ace of clubs here. Nice, 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 nice. 52k. What a clean one. He calls 8-5. Dream, dream, dream spot. Now we're fifth in chips on the stone bubble in the hot 82. So he limps. Now he pots turn. Really? What is he representing here? What does he limp? I'm gonna call. I mean, a guy that raises A7 in the small blind? Yeah. What did he have? Did we get there on the river? No, he has King 8. He has the bluff. Obviously, he has the bluff. What a nice turn call, Henry. Let's go. Time machine. We can just bet small here versus him. He doesn't play with flop check raises, I think. At least not many at all. So I'm just gonna triple barrel again here with 8 duels. He just has a really, really tough time calling river here. Pretty often. But because he has like a lot of pairs, he has one pairs with like a flush straight draw. This time he calls down pocket 8s. Seems like a good bluff catcher. He should obviously just 3-bet that preflop again. We got it in preflop here and win the flip. Nice. So we do bluff away a bunch of chips there, but I think it's a really reasonable bluff. Sick setup. Yeah, I mean, that sucked a bit, but no, we're still in. Just gotta come back here. Ugh, sucks so hard, man. That's what I mean. Like, heads up just comes down to a couple of these spots, you know, like get cool at once. run a bluff where you get hero called. By the way, nice hero call. And, you know, things don't look good anymore. And now we just need to lose a flip and we're out. Thanks, XDJ. Gonna limp this. It's just absolute devastation if he rejams over a race with this hand. So let's see a flop. I mean, it's kind of weird. Like, he did check ace check behind, you know? Like, maybe he just has overpairs here, especially with that sizing. This is one would be a fucking ridiculous for a fold. Let's see what the turn brings. Okay, I mean, that answers the question pretty much. Good luck. Yeah, right back in there. So he does pot with two overcards. I mean, it just doesn't make sense what he's doing, obviously. He just plays random style. Like, if you raise king queen suited, why wouldn't you raise his check? Alright, so he 3-bets. Alright, this one is going in preflop. Okay, okay, okay. Come on, back in the chip lead. And now we just bet to protect. He's gonna fold 100% here, right? Nope. Let's see what he has. Check 10. Yeah. I have such a fucking sick read on that guy. Like with the queen 10 earlier, with the check 10 there, like, oh, this is usually, like, we should win this heads up pretty often, I think. Let's play some more heads up. Let's call here. Let's see a 12k bet. Ooh, a check back. Okay. I'm gonna give him a raise here. Just protect my hand a bit. And hopefully he goes check, check, and he shows 6-7 of hearts. Nice. And he had ace 10. Really? Ace 10 without a club and doesn't bluff it? This guy's crazy. I think we see a bit small here. Oh, yeah, okay, so sick, so sick. Elke is a nice guy indeed. So this guy's just, what the fuck, was our French program? This guy's a legend. Yeah, Elke is an absolute legend. Like, when I used to stream for the King's Journey, he was, like, hanging out there occasionally and stuff. I'm going for the 3-bet here. Oh, yeah, I wanted to go for 42. I kind of misread things here. Doesn't make a big difference. Made myself some chips. Nice. We're working in the right direction again. We had him down last time when we lost two pair over two pair. Now we're getting in the right direction again. No, you can't pay on Poker Market with a credit card. The thing is, like, Poker Market is just, they organize things, but I take care of all the money business. So you send it to my Stars account and I accept you and all of that stuff. So I can't accept, like, a credit card payment for staking. The Fan 83. Do we want to fold these highs here? I mean, I'm not sure how many cards them, but yeah, I'm gonna fire a second one. Fold. Alright, I'm gonna give up. Wow, he does hero call with the ace high on the turn. Sick, sick, sick. Gotta be careful about him now. So Fan83 and Meschenstein. Danke für die Follows. Thanks for Follows, guys. Welcome home. Gotta be careful, man. He's in hero calling mood, guys. We're gonna shut down a bit and do it with value next time. I mean, at least 7 turn call. Like, I was pretty sure he would fold there. Check it back here. All right. Let's hope he has a 7. Thanks for the subs, guys. Welcome home. Let's go. From here, open King Jack Suited UTG, bet a third on the flop, he calls, firing two thirds on the turn. Hope he floated us with an ace high on the flop. Nope. GL, thanks, dude. Yeah, I just like these small seabirds should work so good against this type of fish. But now he discovered the race for him. Like, this is the second time he does it, so maybe it's time to shut down a bit. Ooh, this could be a fun one. This could be a fun one. Pretty good spot. Nice, it's another bounty in the KO. Good stuff. Alright, back in the chip lead. Oh, heads up poker, hey. Come on, through at me, baby. No. Stop going to ship the thread again. What a life, dude. I don't think we should be folding with that bet sizing. Yeah, now we just have a really clear river bluff and just hope he doesn't have a 5. Man, he's in there for in the hero calling mood, like, doesn't give a fuck. It's a bit of a wide float, I understand, but the sizing on the flop is just small. Alright, come on, let's have something here, mate. So sick, man. Like, he never has a fucking bluff here. Like, never, 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 ever. But maybe he has, like, an ace X with a spade. But then he fires river so often, I fear. I'm really just folding here. Oh, my God. I'm going for the super tight lay down. I just don't see the bluff. I don't see it. Thanks for the donor, man. Sorry for the bad timing there. For 13 fucking K, are you kidding me? G fucking G at home for him, man. Awesome, dude. Awesome, awesome, awesome. GG. That is a big one, man. Thanks for the $5. Good luck. BAM! Come on. I mean, you can regen like queen jack of spades, you know, so it's like, I don't think we should ever fold there. Man, Conquest on 13k, that's big, man, that's big. Especially when we're like $27 buy-in, that's just like ridiculous. Wow, he doesn't have check 4, man. Just doesn't do it. It's kind of weird, man. I'm not really sure. I'm not sure what I think here. Like, I'm a bit confused again. That was a really, really important pot there. King high, be good. And we threw a gem ace queen here for 20 blinds. Hold. 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 Yeah. Look at this one, guys. Third of 29 and hotter 82. Sick. Sick, sick, sick. Let's do it, man. Final table Laro today. Holy shit. Come on. Oh, we get check raise and have a set. Let's call. That is the turn where he should give up a bunch. He goes for the 2x re-raise. Actually a bit bigger. Wow, can I fold here? 22k into 54? What do we think? Yeah, we should call. He checks turn. Gonna bet a third. And take it down pretty often. Yeah, I think the call is correct versus him. Because we saw him, like, he doesn't have a polarized 3-betting range necessarily. Like, he's gonna have a bunch of king-queen suited and stuff. And then 8-7 gets the right price to call. Maybe you can check it down to the river and hit a club. He makes the call on the turn after tanking a bit. This guy jams 10 blinds, we obviously ISO. Yeah, just gonna rejam. We're never folding if the big blind rejams here, so I might as well rejam myself. Check check flop, check check turn. I'm not even bluffing river with my 8 high. Big blind folded 10s, exactly, that's what we wanted to happen. That's the reason I rejammed. We exactly want to see that 10s fold. I'm gonna check it here. Hit ace 10, seems reasonable. He jams, open jams river now. I mean, would suck if you lose this one. Wow, that's pretty sick. A7 is just not our hand today, it seems. And we're gonna 3-bet him here. GG in the red to 40. That's 240 bucks gone. Let's hope we win some other tournament to make up for it. Okay. God, I hate this guy. Stop raising me when I don't have it. Or when I have it, but the turn brings the flush. It kind of feels like a spot where, like, he might, like, go for the loose 4-bet jam here. I really hope that happens. Just give him ace queen and give him a cooler. Come on, man, you creak. I 3-bet you a bunch. Okay. We'll size up slightly versus him. If he has like a set here or two pair, obviously we're just going broke. There's just not gonna be a way around that with top pair, top kicker here. Alright, less than 200k now. Come on. I probably shouldn't open any two versus him. Unless I get through though. Not a bad flop. Let's just hit the turn. There it is. And now we just snap at 2/3 and get hero called by something. Come on, dude. Maybe shouldn't snap at. I thought my chance was a bit higher to get called there. Gonna limp this again. Once again, raise folding 90s really just sucks. So I'd rather bit more polarized in my raises. Gonna c-bet here. Just has a bunch of shitty hands. I do 7 after he has to fold immediately, which I definitely take. Alright, less than 20 blinds for him. Let's do it, guys. I think 8-7 off plays better as a raise. Just because it doesn't flop quite as good. We saw him check jam before this SPR, so I like checking back my open ender here and go for a delayed bluff. So let's do that. Fuck. Here he goes for the turn check jam, man. That's something that like never happens in MTTs. I was smart for checking the flop. You know, it was a good idea, but it just sucks that it happens like that. Man, I feel like we're just getting heroed if I bet. That seems good. Check jam on me or not on the turn, dude. Give him the raise and just hope he doesn't have a straight or a better two pair. Please don't open push. Oh, I'm really going for the nitty check here. I'm gonna do that. Alright, not sure if A9 calls river. It's a pretty tight check. Could be a rejam with King 9 here for 19 blinds. He raises a lot. I should call, yeah. Usually I would bluff here, I think, but then I just check it and take my showdown value. Okay. I don't know, I had a feeling there, so I kind of wanted to go for the sick hero. Oh dear. I was wrong. Don't bet turn, please. One fold king queen here. Let's hope we hit a king or queen on the river. Let's hope he just checks it back with check 10. Nice. Good one. Good pot. Good pot. He had 8-10. What? He has 8-10 and double barrels that? What the fuck? He's just so random now. Okay, at first I thought he was like having somewhat of a game plan here, but like seeing that 8-10 off double barrel and ace 8-4 king is just. It's just pretty damn absurd. I think leading that makes a lot of sense. Alright, he's like 15 blinds now. Alright, he's pretty done right now, it seems. This would be it. I'm not folding this for 20 blinds. Ever. You got my shit. You're as ugly as a frog. Have I got my shit? Come on, jam it. Alright. He jams 3 blinds. Let me call here. Hold. Ooh, sweaty. Rip. Call here. For my last 2 blinds, just re-blinded down this FT. Maybe some chops with a 5. GG. 7 high takes it down. He limps it. I'm just gonna jam this for like 18, 19 blinds. Hold! Hold! Bam! Run good Lero, man. Taking down another MTT, 1900 locked up. Unbelievable, guys. Unbelievable. The fucking heater we're on, man. We also cash for 363 on the bounty, 63 Hunter Fine Table on Natural 8. Wow! Wow! Shouts to 2,700 people watching right now. G fucking G, guys. 1,900 bucks right there. Wow. And somebody wished for the chip graph. And there you go. This is where we had like one big blind left and made another comeback and then swing heads up and up top in the end. 1891. Be unstoppable. Fucking sick heater, we're on. Sick, sick heater. Wow. Just win another MTT, hey?